This is how we're going to do this right now. Freddie Mercury style. You too. You're okay, cigar guy.
I'll just chill out.
Repeat after me. Hey-o.
Hey-o.
La-da-da-da-da.
La-da-da-da. I can't do this.
You did it.
I'm gay.
I'm gay.
Dino just mouthed it. He didn't say anything. He is such a homophobe. We have Cigar Guy co-hosting.
What's up, brothers?
We have King Croc supposedly going to show up.
He's coming through.
Swolby supposedly going to show up.
Big time.
We're going to be talking about Cigar Guy and King Croc's trip to the strip club last night. My trip to Sacramento with my girlfriend this weekend. Had to stay at my parents' house. And you know what that means?
Covert.
Sex.
Yes.
Tough to pull off. You can count on a guy like me to figure out a way to make it happen, though.
Wow.
And before we get to any of that, we're going to make contact with the one, the only, Rat Dick Ralph.
Oh, man.
Give him a call, Austin. Give him a call.
Here we go.
Hey! Oh!
Hey! Oh!
La-da-da-da-da!
Yo, what's up, baby?
Rat Dick, I'm going to sing a couple notes. You echo them back.
Wait, start over. What is it?
Not too bad.
It's all right.
The last note sounded a little flat, but cellular connection problems.
Not the best on-spot singer.
Rat Dick, what are you under the influence of right now?
Well, I'm on a... I stayed up all last night off some tabs, some cocaine. We had a pretty long night last night. Just up all night, you know. It was a good night, though.
Who was doing cocaine at that party? Who was doing cocaine with you?
I was doing cocaine with some really famous artists, supposedly. And, like, this guy that looked like fucking... looked like a rock... like James Morrison. It was so trippy,
James,
dude.
Morrison.
Oh, James.
Yeah, Jim Morrison.
Is that his real name? Probably is James Morrison. That might be his real name.
He might be ahead of the game here.
Like that.
It's probably all a hallucination. The reason I asked... RDR is because I saw you were hanging out with Reckless Ben, who I don't think likes our channel and is probably scheming and trying to use you as a way of like fucking us over somehow. So I was just trying to get you to admit that he did coke.
He says he really digs your channel.
Uh-huh.
He says like all
yeah,
the
sure.
beef, you know, he's like,
yeah,
like
yeah.
He says I don't really think he has any resentment towards you at all.
We determined a couple of episodes ago that he is autistic, so I don't think he has any beef against anybody, but he still behaves in a way that's destructive to various people. It's not a big deal. We're fucking around. But Rat Dick, tell me about life since this triumphant video has come out.
Mm-hmm. Oh, dude, this video that just came out, it's a fucking beauty, boys. It's a classic. It's a classic. Mm-hmm. Is Leo with you right now?
No, Leo's not here. Isn't he starting to sound like Marty McFly from Canada?
He is.
This video, it's a fucking beauty, boys. It really is. Huh?
Yeah, it was really good, though. You know, I got Barry Mace 7 times. I took it like a fucking champ.
That is not true.
You know?
Yeah.
7 times. You can't say 7 sprayed.
I'm not denying
sprayed.
The count. I'm denying that you took it like a man because I was with you. All the audience saw was a 1 minute cut of your reaction. I was with you for the full 30 minutes while you were crying like a bitch, Red Dick.
I was crying like a bitch, dude. I know. You really should have put me like butt naked walking. I guess you can't really show my cock on YouTube, but
if only.
I mean, I remember when I walked out of the bathroom just butt naked and you guys had the milk. It was pretty hilarious.
Yeah, I want to say this too. If penises look a certain amount of big during normal circumstances, after the owner of the penis has been maced, they shrink up to almost nothing. So in Rat Dick's case, that is very damaging. And you should be thankful it wasn't shown on YouTube, your penis.
Oh, yeah, it shrunk up. It shrunk up, I'm sure. Mm-hmm. I can only imagine.
I saw it, Ralph. This is Cigar Guy, man. How you doing?
Oh, what's up, brother? How are you doing?
I'm all right, man. Doing? I'm better than when I was when I saw your shriveled up penis, man. It was just a head. There was no shaft.
It was pretty bad, boys. It was pretty bad.
Cigar Guy, I was making fun of his dick, but you don't have to shame him directly.
It looked
like
a clitoris, man.
Come on.
Hey, but it's bigger than mud flaps. That's all that matters.
Not according to Bill, one antique broker and Bishop.
I honestly think that I came up fourth or maybe even third place in the cock measuring contest.
Yeah, well, because you honestly think you were doing coke with Jim Morrison last night. We don't know what to believe, Marty.
It was gnarly. I wish you were there, Danny. I was telling Ben, like, hey, we need to get Danny here right now.
I'm sure he would have liked that. I'm sure he would have loved it, in fact.
I'm sure he would have, you know? We've all been partying together.
Yeah. Well, I don't know if you're aware of this, Rattic. He's put out two videos recently that their entire purpose was to attack the Danny Mullen regime. So I'm not sure how I feel about this.
I really don't think he meant any harm by that. I don't understand Rattic, the whole drama that he has with you.
You said you didn't mean any harm when you went on your England Iggy is an N-word, I'm going to kill England Iggy rant.
That's true. That did happen. That
it
did
comes
happen
off differently to different people. Everything. There's RDR reality, and then there's objective reality.
That's true.
RDR. So,
So, the thing with Ben is he has this roommate who he wants to be my manager for the Rattic Ralph. I actually want to make my own channel to help boost Rattic, you know?
You got to boost possibly, the Rattic.
Because I don't just want to be, like, you know, just known for being a side character. Yeah. I want to actually be Rattic Ralph.
Rattic,
you know?
They're fucking with you. That's what they do.
You think they're trying to plan some piece of content by managing Rattic Ralph?
Well, no, not that. I think they actually want me to do better and become Rattic Ralph and make my own channel, possibly. And, like, yesterday we did, like, some infiltration of Scientology. We tried to, I know Ben already did this. Yeah. But we went to I tried to break into Scientology.
Mm-hmm.
It was pretty bad. They called the police on me. Mm. I didn't try to break in or anything, but I just tried to get in. And I have this, like, gnarly hand sore right now. I felt, like, hot oil in my hand.
Of course.
I was, like, asking Scientology to, like, heal my wounds and everything. It was fucking hilarious, Danny.
I can actually see Rattic becoming a gigantic disciple of Scientology.
I think they just gave him the right speech.
One thing, Rattic Ralph, Austin, we'll get to what you're getting at in a second. What did Reckless Ben's roommate say his duties as your manager were going to be, Rattic?
Mm. Okay, so his duties are to manage my social media presence.
What does that mean? He's going to post everything for you and edit your videos?
Basically. Rattic, Michael, I don't know how to edit videos.
One second. Okay, he said he's going to essentially do all the work involved with being a social media person.
He's going to be my Leo. You know, if you're Rattic Ralph, he looks just like Leo.
He's going to be your... Wait, so is he going to be your Leo or is he going to be your manager? Because I'm going to tell you something. Leo certainly does not manage all of my content, Rattic. Is that what Leo's been saying behind the scenes?
No.
Listen, so you guys think Danny fucking, you know, edits his own videos? I do all of that, okay? You know, the writing, that happens with fucking, you know, my sugar mama sends me some money. I check into a hotel. I bang out the scripts.
Oh, shit.
You are the mastermind behind all of your videos. Without you, dude, nothing would even work, dude. I'd just be walking around looking like a fucking idiot. So
let's get back to this management deal.
I don't really know how to do Rattic without Danny Mullen because I just walking around looking like a fucking, you know, a crazy person.
Yeah.
But if I have you to guide me, it just brings it all together. You know what I'm saying?
First of all, I'll say I agree. But second of all, Rattic, last night, try to remember through the cocaine haze, all the grogginess brought on by the booze. What else did this guy say he was going to do for you?
The guy that was dressed up like Jim Morrison?
No. No.
Your manager, Rattic.
I'm curious what he said he was going to do for you too, actually, but we'll get to him second.
Yeah, he was going to do a lot for me. There was also some trannies at the party that me and this one guy were. We didn't get too far, but I don't know.
How far did Reckless Ben go with the tranny?
It could have been a tranny. It was a black tranny, and it was a big black tranny.
And did Reckless Ben blow it?
No. Ben, he abstains from
tranny fucking.
And tranny dick. So he did not snort any of the cocaine, and he was not down. Well, I mean, the tranny looked at me and my friend, this artist guy that was hanging out with King Croc, and the tranny just looked at us, and she was like, I am so horny right now. And I think of Rat Pussy Pam, and I'm like, dude, I can't do this to Rat Pussy Pam. She's going to fucking kill me.
Yeah.
And so I just look at my friend. I don't know. I get up. I don't know if it's a tranny or not. So I just get up and walk away.
Yeah.
It was gnarly.
I want to let everybody listening know that Rattic Ralph and Rat Pussy Pam, they carry on their relationship to a very high standard of monogamy.
Yes.
Except for that time.
Hey, we're better.
Except for that one time at that one meetup by Griffith Observatory when Rattic and a random Danny Mullen fan double teamed Rat Pussy Pam.
Yeah, some crazy shit happened. It was for the boys, but it was also just a bad time in Ratchet Ralph's early.
Was it for the boys? I guess it was for the boys because we got a lot of amusement out of it.
Yeah.
It was a gift in
it
a
sense.
It
was for the boys.
Yeah.
It was for the boys.
Yeah, and you said
for those boys that were with me and Pam that night.
You said he had a bigger penis than you. Well, I don't even know why, of course.
Well, it's kind of hard to not have a bigger penis than Ratchet Ralph.
Sure.
The people at the party last night, in order to get cocaine, they were like, you need to show us your cock. And I'm like, are you guys sure you want to see my cock? I just did a dick measuring contest with Danny Mullen, and I came in last place.
Mm-hmm.
And they were like, what the fuck? I'm like, do you still want to see my cock? And they're like, no, don't show us your cock. And I'm like, I was kind of hoping they would ask to actually see it. But
that was the deal breaker,
it,
so. That you had been in a dick measuring contest and they wanted to see it before?
And I came in last place. They were hoping I had a huge cock.
I would
want to
see it,
you know,
more in that situation.
Yeah, absolutely. That's a novelty.
Yeah.
I mean, anybody can have a middle-of-the-road penis. That's
boring.
Yeah,
but the smallest out of a group of strapping men?
Small or large, on the wings of the bell curve, those are the penises you want to see.
Yeah, exactly, man.
Yeah.
The Ripley's Believe It or Not penises. No. Small is good, too, Rattic. You have a gift.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I don't really know where we're going.
I don't know if it's a gift necessarily, but
no, it's a gift, Rattic.
I ride with it.
Rattic, you know what's insane too is that the name Rattic was the first thing to come. Mm-hmm. I cooked up. I just said I want a guy named Rattic
before
in our Rattic crew. Then Rattic came along, and then Rattic incidentally had a rat dick.
A rat dick.
Fucking crazy.
Dude, you owe me a fucking soda, bro. I knew you were going to say that. I did have a rat dick, bro.
That's how that works.
How fucking crazy is that? It's like it was meant to be, dude.
I think he's having a flashback to some sixth grade
game. I actually am meant to be rat dick fucking Ralph. And this is my second chance coming back.
Absolutely. And you did well. You did very well, rat dick. But I'm a little nervous that you're doing coke with Jim Morrison into the wee hours.
Yep.
There are black hookers.
Yeah.
And you're already falling into the Hollywood wolf trap.
Uh-huh.
Scumbag suits are coming at you trying to manage your ass, and I want to protect you
from
that. You know how many suits have come for me, Rat Dick Ralph, and I've had to slam phones down and kick them in the nuts over cocktails in Beverly Hills?
I've seen it happen.
Mm-hmm.
You've seen it happen?
Yeah.
Yeah, it was with my own eyes, man. It was brutal.
Yeah.
A guy came at me and he was like, so I would love to negotiate your contract with Nabisco. Of course, I'll be collecting my standard fee.
Yep.
5%. Before he could say 5%, I smashed a martini glass into his jaw.
I took a sip of my Shirley Temple and just tried to turn away and not be involved. It was brutal.
Yeah. Cigar guy was there. He was the mediator.
Yeah.
But that sounds more like he was trying to, like, corporate, like, wolf you type shit. He was trying to take your money.
That's
just
what's happening,
like,
to you, Rattic.
He's trying to get a percentage. But this guy that I got, he hasn't even asked me for any money.
Not yet.
This guy's not actually going to be your manager. He doesn't manage anyone. Every single one of Reckless Ben's videos involves Reckless Ben's roommate pretending to be the manager or production guy on, like, it's,
you think I'm getting punked right now?
You're being punked 100%. Yeah. 120%, because I know I've filmed with Ben like 3 times. This is how he does stuff.
Do I have some right to be a little annoyed here that Reckless Ben, after putting out 2 hatchet jobs about my channel, is actively seeking out 2 members of our squad, King Croc and Rattic, and is trying to use them to make content?
King Croc, too?
Well, King Croc
really
was there. He said King Croc was there.
No, he wasn't.
I really don't know if he's trying
That's
to, like,
what Rattic just said.
Rattic, was this last night?
Wait, what happened?
Was this all last night?
Who did I call last night?
Oh, my God. Was King Croc with you last night?
Oh, no. King Croc was not there.
Yeah, because he was just with me at a strip club.
It was just me.
There's holes in your
story,
buddy.
The guy, Deezy, and Mills Coolin.
And Jim Morrison. I feel a little better about this. Okay.
Yeah.
If it's just Rattic. But Rattic, they're definitely trying to use you for another Danny Mullen hit piece. Austin and I are thinking the same thing.
Reckless Ben will hang out with somebody for like 3 or 4 days just as friends, pretend to be their friend, and then prank them. Like, he did it with the Flat Earth guys and other stuff. Yeah, you're being punked, dude.
Were you being filmed last night by them?
No, not last night. We just went to the... Well, we went slacklining because we filmed the Scientology thing. I was trying to infiltrate Scientology. He said he was going to use some of it on his channel.
So he was filming
you.
And then we went slacklining after that to the beach. And then he said afterwards we could come to this party because there was going to be like some like weed carts people there. And then, you know, we got to the party and it went crazy, you know?
See, Ratdick, I want you to bring out right now RDR circa spring 2020 in the front seat of your car, screaming into your Instagram story for 20 straight stories. If Reckless Ben approaches you again, that's the energy I want you to unleash. See, I'm not seriously upset with Reckless Ben, and I know I've been accused of blacklisting, but isn't it strange that people do this? Like, imagine me following around Danny Duncan's squad and trying to do videos with any periphery character that ever appeared in a Danny Duncan video.
That is kind of gnarly.
I mean, I think it's for his own gain. I'm just thinking. I don't know. He might just wanting to be. Ratdick, I highly doubt he's just wanting to be your good buddy.
I think this is all part of his prank that he's trying to pull on Danny.
Yeah,
it seems like
this is a good mystery.
You're contributing to an attack on the Danny Mullen channel. How does that feel, Ratdick?
Well, I actually did ask him what the $3,000 that he raised, you know, that for whatever he was going to do, you know, he raised that money, whatever. I asked him what it's going to. And he told me that he doesn't know what to, he told me he doesn't want to tell me because I'm with you, but he also doesn't want to tell me because he doesn't like I don't know he doesn't he might he kind of just wants to drop it he I don't know he's telling me he just wants to drop all of the drama supposedly because he doesn't see like any how any
so is he
gonna
return all
anymore.
That money.
I think Ratdick could be a good secret agent.
I am kind of like a CIA member right now, you know, on both sides.
Yeah, you would totally pass all the drug tests they require too.
Yeah, no, definitely not.
Ratdick, okay, let's drop all the heavy stuff. I want to hear about the first time you made love to Rat Pussy Pam after that video dropped. Was it especially sweet?
After the Death Valley video?
Yeah.
Oh, it was like coming back to my old ways. It was like something else, you know. Ratdick came back, you know. It's like it came back, you know.
Did the Ratdick grow three sizes that day?
And once I was awakened from my inner shell, it was like a firecracker.
Uh-oh.
It just happened, you know.
That scares me.
This doesn't sound good.
It was just an extreme burst. That's a good way to put it.
I came out of my shell and I woke up and there was a dead hooker on my doorstep the next morning. I don't know where she came from.
Jesus.
That is what happened.
And Rat Pussy Pam had a bruised kidney. And all the booze in my apartment complex was drank.
Oh, Jesus, dude.
Oh, we're fucking. Yeah. We're fucking with you, Ratdick. Ratdick, we're gonna bring you back real soon. Everybody loved your performance.
Excited.
Everybody
I'm
loved
excited.
Your performance in Death Valley. If they say they
Hell
don't,
yeah,
they're lying, and they're probably a Reckless Ben fan.
Mm. Yeah, they're just stupid, you know. And honestly, like, I really feel like the only thing I was missing from the last video was Jerry and Leo, you know, just the rest of the crew, just, you know, being all of ourselves and just going at it, you know, and just being, you know, being crazy, Danny Mullen style. That's what your channel is about, just fucking being crazy, and I'm down.
Hey, I want to say right now, before we part ways, or before we sever this telephone call, Ratdick, that you did great in Death Valley. My favorite part of the video, is it all right if I tell you?
Yeah, tell me, I'd like to know.
Interviewing the girl at Badwater Basin. I'm Johnny D with Explore, Explore, Explore. Is it all right to swim? Yeah, you could probably swim. Well, we're about to try it out, Ratdick style.
He went
Ratdick style, belly flop in there.
Ratdick Ralph, baby, here we go.
Ratdick Ralph, baby, hell yeah.
Why were there so many
hats? You know what I thought was your
thing?
Favorite part, Danny? I thought
tradition?
When I took the big ass rip of the Methuselah.
Yeah.
And I just blew out my nose, and you just laughed hysterically. I was like, hell yeah, Danny fucking digs that shit. I took a big ass rip. You know what I mean? That's what you took me out there for, to smoke the fucking tree. And I took the biggest rip.
You took a fat fucking
rip. My inner knowledge was awakened after that.
Yeah.
You know?
I think you're going to have access to secrets the universe has long held secret.
Oh, I'm excited. I'm going to keep it chill this time, baby. Ratchet's going to be around for, you know, a while, you know. It's going to be cool. And I'm not going to let anybody manage me, you know, but I actually do have my own Ratchet Ralph video up right now. It's reviewing the very first Danny Mullen video.
I saw it.
So I do want to, I do want to, you know, go places with this Ratchet Ralph thing. And
sure.
Maybe whoever, you know, I don't know, man. We'll talk about it more on our next shoot, you know?
Sure.
I'm going to get my own content up there.
Ratdick, is it all right if I promote that? We link that in the bio. And then also, is the Instagram account Ratdick Ralph, the new one that's just been created, is that indeed you?
That's not me. Would you like me to create a new Instagram?
Yeah, I think it'd be fun.
So who followed me with all these pictures that have not been previously published of you?
Probably Reckless Ben's roommate.
Oh, is that your manager behind that?
Your manager is posting content of you, posing as you without your consent, Rat Dick.
That's the sketchy part, you know, because I don't really know how to upload videos. So I have this guy doing it for me.
Oh, no.
I trust him, but, you know, he could always turn on me in any second, and then he has access to the Rat Dick Ralph YouTube page. So it's kind of sketchy.
Yeah.
But it should be cool.
He already uploaded a video for you?
Yeah, it's up. It has 150 views. I have like 30 subscribers already.
Okay, Rat Dick, stop talking to this guy. Change the password of the YouTube account and watch a 2-minute tutorial video on how to upload an iPhone video. That's all you need. You don't need management at this stage of your career, Rat Dick.
I don't need management yet.
All right, buddy.
You're probably right.
Rat Dick?
You're probably right, man.
You working today? You're probably on the clock right now, huh?
I'm actually on the clock right now. I'm supposed to go knock on some doors.
$20 an hour. $20 an hour
for what
he's doing.
$20 an hour, baby.
Wow. Yeah,
it's the life. I'm living it.
Any sales today?
Style, baby.
Any leads?
You know, I haven't gotten any leads today, but I feel like after this phone call, I'm just going to go kill it. You know,
close
it just
deals.
Really picked up my Rat Dick spirits. I'm going to go kill it out there.
How many doors have you knocked on today?
Today, I've hit about 24 doors. And I'm supposed to be at like 45 by now. So I'm kind of slacking, chilling, smoking dabs out here.
You're
but
smoking
dabs when you're
between doors.
You make your own hours. Create your own.
Wow.
Create your own day.
I'm honestly just surprised you're in the double digits. Rat Dick, keep knocking on those doors. Keep trying to sell solar, and when in doubt, whip it out.
Whip it out, Rat Dick style, baby. And Danny, I'll see you soon.
Whipped.
Let me know when the next Rat Dick Ralph video shoot is, and I'll be there, man. Let's go skydiving on acid.
Doesn't have much dangle to it.
Yeah,
huh?
No dang.
Yeah, skydiving on acid, Rat Dick. We're gonna make this happen. All right, buddy.
Yeah,
go
bro,
sell
it's
some
insane.
Solar.
I'm actually kind of nervous, but we're gonna do it, dude. All right, have a good day, guys. I love you guys.
Rat Dick Ralph.
Later, Rat Dick.
Peace.
Rat Dick Ralph, baby.
Yep.
Later, dude.
Later, man.
Rat Dick could be trying to close a sale and be like,
Rat Dick,
I'm gonna show you
Ralph,
my dick. Hey, if it's the, if it's the smallest dick you've ever seen.
He just hung up. I was gonna say, Austin, you have to hang up on him. He's never gonna hang up on his dick. You're saying he's gonna use his dick as leverage in a sale.
Yeah, he could be like, I'll show you my dick, and if it's the smallest dick you've ever seen, you gotta buy it.
I haven't thought
you're
much about
closer,
this.
Austin.
He'd
suppose
sell a lot of
you're
TVs
a closer, dude.
Whatever it is.
Yeah, that sounds great to me.
Is that knocking?
No, that's your headphone cable smashing against the desk.
Oh, it's my big dome swinging that thing.
And now it's going to distract me that you brought this up. Here's what you do. You wind this along the pole here.
Some windage?
A little windage. If you need to bring your seat closer, bring it a little closer.
I can do some windage.
I'm going to talk about right now my weekend at home.
Let's hear it.
That's a big milestone, huh? Bringing your girlfriend home to the parents?
Is that the first time?
Really?
They've met her before.
But bringing her home for an overnight stay.
Yes.
That's crazy.
Crazy might be overselling.
No, that's crazy to me.
We sat around watching American Idol auditions, which, by the way, that used to be the best show that ever existed.
I heard it was horrible. I saw an article about it.
Okay, so now it's horrible. But my girlfriend, my mom, and my dad and me in Sacramento, there's fucking nothing to do.
Yeah.
I guess right now they've just reopened Sacramento and the lines are literally hours long to get into any sort of bar or restaurant.
To watch American Idol?
No.
Oh.
To go out and party. So nightlife was out of the question.
Yeah.
I go to bed super early anyway. So we sat around doing fucking nothing.
Mm.
But we were watching the early episodes of American Idol.
So funny.
It's the best show ever.
It's so funny.
It's really good.
It is a polished, high-budget version of the Danny Mullen channel that's a little bit more PC, but only a little bit.
Yeah.
Simon Cowell is cracking racist jokes.
He doesn't give a fuck.
Fat jokes, destroying people's dreams,
yeah,
bringing them to tears and to their knees.
He loves it.
For an audience of millions. I saw a clip of him on Howard Stern during the peak of all the American Idol shit. In 2002, he's talking about Victoria's Secret models he fucked.
No.
He did not give a shit, dude. And Ryan Seacrest is a complete Leo DiTavio style straight man. And, like, for instance, this fucking big fucking fat chick comes and she's got these two friends. They look like three goblins. Have you seen the movie Hercules?
The animated
one? Yeah. Aren't there a couple little like fat and skinny demon guys?
The little skinny three trio?
Like Dionysus or something like that.
Maybe. Like,
some weird shit.
These girls looked like a collection of Hellspawn from Hades that had come to Earth. And you can tell every producer on American Idol says, oh my God, this is going to be gold. I don't know if this girl can sing or not. I'm betting on the latter.
Yeah.
And we need to get them to make fools of themselves. Wow. So they have these girls out in the middle of the New York City subway dancing around with their fat bellies flopping all over the place. Ryan Seacrest is asking the girls about their influences. Who do you think you look like? What celebrity do you think you look like?
Brutal.
The fat girl goes, I think I look like a mix of Mariah Carey and Britney Spears. Really? You know, I agree with that contention, says Ryan.
They send
these fucking chicks in to Simon and Randy Jackson.
Uh-huh.
Randy Jackson, by the way, is the bassist for Journey now, by the way. I didn't realize. Dude, he's a badass bassist.
Really?
I didn't realize that.
With the Asian Journey singer?
I think so, yeah.
Crazy.
But he's a sick musician. I didn't know that back in the day, so I respect him more. But these girls come in, they sing their... Time goes by so slowly. And Simon is just like, you are honestly the worst singer I've ever heard in my life. Really? I'm not joking. You have no business remaining in this industry. And the girls walk out crying. The fat girl, the average girl, and the skinny girl.
Yeah.
And after they walk out, Simon turns to Randy Jackson and says, it looks like the before, after, and during of Weight Watchers. I stood up and applauded in my parents' living room. And I thought, this is incredible. This is the best show that I can ever remember seeing on mainstream television. Recently, too, my girlfriend and I watched the new version of American Idol, and it's really symbolic of what's happening in our culture right now. They don't show any bad auditions. None of the judges. It's Lionel Richie, Kate Perry, and some country faggot. That was rude. He's not actually gay. I'm not using that as a slur, but
they
are so bland. They are so positive. They are so afraid to tell the truth. It's not even about race and sexuality and income gaps and whatever these insane social justice battles are going on right now. It's just nowadays you can't even be honest or quote unquote mean.
Yeah.
That's what American Idol has taught me.
That's what I grew up watching American Idol purely for the bad auditions and Simon Cowell. Quick whips.
Yeah. I mean, dude, even when they went to Hollywood and the singers were good on American Idol, Simon Cowell could still be hilarious when he ripped apart somebody because they had a bad night.
Yeah. I mean, I honestly never watched the Hollywood segment. I only watched the first auditions where they got the one-legged fucking wheelchair dude coming in trying to sing some Chuck Berry pirate guy. Yeah, you know.
Arr, this be Johnny be good. That's Chuck Berry, right?
Yeah.
How does Johnny B. Good go again?
It's just a ripping guitar riff. Johnny B. Good? I don't know, dude. It's fucking
good. I'm thinking of the Velvet Underground. Johnny B. Good, what you should. I got that melody in my head.
No, it's like some rock and roll Back to the Future high school auditorium bullshit.
Well, I can't. Play Johnny B. Good. Let us get copyright striked.
It's worth it.
All of our videos are no longer getting monetized on this channel, by the way.
I couldn't believe they ever were.
Yeah, we had a golden interim where every video, even if the title was the Leo and Danny Show Dating Game, or Abel and Iggy gets knocked unconscious in Vegas.
Yeah.
Danny has a threesome. They would just monetize every video, and it was sweet. We need to hear Johnny.
What was the moment that stopped? Was there a specific
4 weeks ago?
4 weeks ago.
Yeah.
Wonder what the YouTube guy behind his desk saw that was like,
4 weeks ago. What was going on around then? I don't know. Let's just let the rock and roll play after this word from State Farm.
Yeah.
But
what do you think about the new State Farm guy?
Okay, we...
This was getting the girls wet back then, dude.
Let's see some moves, Dino. Some 1950s moves.
Dude, have you ever seen Austin dance?
I don't want it.
It's great. He's so, like, technically challenged. He's technically, like, he's a dancer.
No.
Dude, Austin, you have to show
your
moves.
We got to hear the chorus.
Go. Go, Johnny, go. That's it, man.
Go, Johnny, go.
That's some legendary shit, dude.
Go, Johnny, go. Go, Johnny, go. Go.
Bam.
Creamy.
We're good.
That's crazy. Yeah, no, dude. Austin, he whipped it out one night, and it was the most unbelievable thing I've ever seen in my life.
In a good or a bad way?
In a good way. Like, it's crazy, dude.
All right, you know what you have to do, Austin. Dino,
it's so crazy,
get the
dude.
Action cam on Austin while he's over here.
It's so insane.
No.
Austin, put dude, on whatever song you require. Get up and shuffle.
It's, dude, the thing with the arms, man.
All right, let me throw on some dubstep.
Oh, dude, you're about to be blown away.
God, this is going to be awful.
No, you're about to be blown away. This is like Dancing with the Stars kind of shit.
Who? What's a good dubstep? Dubstepper. Okay.
Oh, my God. Our aggressively white conservative producer who's obsessed with hip-hop is going to dance to dubstep.
Yeah, let's do it.
Am I mistaken that you were in a dubstep dance class in high school?
Nah, it was like a club after school, but it was like during school so that we didn't have to do like class stuff. It was pretty dope. I got out of a lot of school for it.
Dude, here we go.
I thought dancing to dubstep is you just take ecstasy and rub your dick on a girl.
No, watch this shit, dude. Yeah.
That's how I danced to dubstep when I was in Vegas during my drug phase. All right. Yeah, over there.
Oh, man.
Austin, get that action camera on him, Dino. Get that action camera dominant on the screen. Austin, is the action cam the dominant camera in it? Great. He's bringing his headphones with him.
He's got to hear the music.
They're on a leash. Yeah. He can't be dancing without no backbeat.
Oh, man.
He's
going to miss the drop, bro.
He doesn't look very confident. I can't imagine this goes well. He says he can do anything. He's being an arrogant prick.
Oh.
He's doing a robot thingy.
Oh, shit, dude. Yeah. Oh, no way, dude. No way. Oh! This is crazy, dude.
Oh, no.
Oh, no, dude.
Oh, my God.
Oh, shit.
Press. You know who I could see doing that in Vegas? Is a 5'4" Asian kid wearing a suit. That's who would do that in Vegas.
Oh my God.
Him and his buddies who work in SF at Google would clear out a space in the back of the Kygo set, and the Asian kid who was the shortest,
ribbit.
The runt of the group would be doing those moves.
Oh man, that was ridiculous, dude.
Austin, never do that again. I had to see for myself.
What did you think? What did you think?
I think I just expressed how I felt about it pretty clearly.
I thought it was gorgeous.
No. All right, please turn this off. I can't take any more.
Oh, this is ridiculous. Dude, the vibrating was nuts.
Yeah.
It was awful. I hated everything about it. It really brings back memories of sock hops in 7th grade and 8th grade when there were nerdy Asian kids who that was their thing.
Yeah, they would be quiet at all times of the day until that moment was their moment.
You know, on their calendar, the 22nd or the 31st or whenever the sock hop was, was circled, had a couple gold stars pasted over it, and then, I don't know, had a fucking...
Dude, they would rip.
A bunch of exclamation marks around it.
You want to see me break dance, though?
No.
I've never seen that shit.
I think we've had enough dancing. We need to spread your dancing out over the next month.
Yeah.
We'll break dance another time.
Where's Croc at?
He's coming. It's okay. But
today was his first day at his new job.
We're going to hear all about it. We're going to hear about your wild night out with him at the strip club last night.
Wild.
I want to talk a little bit about the illicit sex I was having with my girlfriend.
Yes, let's hear it.
So... I do this thing, and I don't know if anybody else can relate to it, but oftentimes I'll go to bed. My girlfriend and I haven't had sex all day.
Mm-hmm.
I used to not be able to envision that. I'd have friends to tell me like, yeah, my girlfriend and I haven't had sex for a couple days, or yeah, it's probably been 2 weeks since we had sex. And I'd be like, what? You haven't fucked your girlfriend in a couple days or weeks, bro? Are you gay? But then I realized, because this is my first long-term girlfriend, that there's more to being in a relationship than just fucking all the time. And there's a lot more. The relationship is 80 to 90% just companionship and then 20 to 10% sex.
100%.
So now it's starting to be more normal to go a day without having sex and going to bed almost platonically. Except I always squeeze her tits before I go out just to make sure they're still there.
It's the nature's melatonin.
Mm. That's correct. Yeah. That's correct, Cigar Guy. You're doing great. We fall asleep, and this has happened to me twice now.
Yeah.
Maybe three times, where around midnight, some sexual poltergeist possesses my body. And I'm not only awake, but I'm on top of my girlfriend and my tongue is down her throat. Jesus. And I'm working on her pajama bottoms.
That happens, man.
It happens to you too.
Well, mine, I do this thing called sleep baiting. And I'll wake up vigorously masturbating.
Wow.
And it's been very, it's been very difficult for me in life, especially when I'm staying at my parents' house when I'm visiting and I'm sleeping on the couch. Mm. And I sleep in because I was out all night.
Yeah.
And my dad's in his chair watching Fox News and my mom's on her computer.
Uh-huh.
And I wake up just vigorously masturbating.
Has that really happened?
I swear it's happened.
Your parents have caught you jerking off in your sleep.
They haven't necessarily caught me. I've caught myself and I look around and they're just doing their thing. And it's incredibly embarrassing.
They don't even want to bring it up because of the embarrassment
it's
for all
so
parties
shocking.
Involved.
It's just, it's shocking.
Well, now my story is going to seem a trifle anticlimactic.
No, I don't think so because...
Jerking off on the couch in front of mom and dad? I can't top that.
Yeah, you can. Because that's another thing. Because yours requires you to rise like Jesus and then go through with the act. You're using your body physically like you're possessed. I'm just laying there with a fucking wrist vibrating. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I still think mine's going to come off way weaker.
Oh,
so
well, let's hear
this
it.
Is what happened. I put on my phone and I put on a Blink-182 song because I found that punk songs are the best for drowning out sex noises or masturbation.
I could see that.
You got to have background noises when you're jerking off or you're fucking at your house. And punk, it just... I mean, you can put on a Neil Diamond song. Mm-hmm. He plays acoustic songs, right?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, people are going to hear the grunts and the smack of skin on skin.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You put on First Date by Blink-182, though. They're going to think it's just a snare or a hi-hat, the smack.
Yeah.
So I start fucking her, and I'm just pounding the shit out of her. And when I have these middle-of-the-night interims, I try to make it as rapey as possible. Because you want to lean into that passion. It's so passionate that sleep couldn't even restrain me.
Jesus.
The Sandman couldn't keep my dick in my pants.
Sandman's sleeping.
The Sandman is sleeping. He's up at a guard tower somewhere and he's falling asleep behind his sniper rifle. Yeah. So I got her fucking in a headlock. I'm pulling on her hair.
Dude, some Brazilian jiu-jitsu shit.
I'm whispering about where my cock is. And then I'm just in her. I'm smacking away. A light goes on behind me.
No.
My mom opens the laundry hamper and we're about 7 horizontal feet away from where she is standing.
In the same room?
No, of course not.
Oh, okay.
I don't live in a house.
Well, I didn't know if you were sleeping on a mattress in the garage. I don't know what your parents' house is like.
What are those old photos of this poor people in the South? Is that Walker Evans?
Oh, like the fucking...
I think those are the Walker... Pull up the Walker Evans photographs, Austin. Walker Evans photographs.
Classic photos.
I'm going to make this joke tentatively and we'll see if it's valid. Yeah. I don't live in a Walker Evans house, okay, cigar guy? This documentary team, it was an author named James Aggie and I think a photographer named Walker Evans. They went down to the deep, deep South to capture on the page and on the photo or on the canvas the condition of these fucking basically indentured servant farmers, and it was miserable and they all lived in one house, 16 people to a family. Mm-hmm. Can you pull one of them up, blow it up? Let me see a poor person.
Okay, let me find a poor person.
Well, King Croc's almost here.
Great. They're all poor, Austin. I can see. These are all the correct photos.
Some of them are
there
quite
we go.
Wealthy.
That's a classic example right there. That's one of the famous photos. I don't live in a house like that, so she was not in the same room.
Okay. Good to know.
And yeah, my mom would have no respect for the closed door policy if they were that, or she was that close to
me. Oh, yeah?
But no, she was through a door and out in the hallway. But still, it was a little embarrassing.
Do you think she heard you?
Yeah, I think so.
Oof.
Have you ever been walked in on?
I've been walked in on masturbating, but I had plausible deniability. I was able to get the blanket over me right in the nick of time.
Mm-hmm.
And though there was sweat dropping down my brow, and though my legs were still locked out, there was lotion on my wrist, there was no proof. You know what I'm saying?
Mm.
My cock and my blurry fist wasn't viewed by my mom directly.
If a jury was involved, you would have been acquitted.
Circumstantial evidence is not enough to put me behind bars.
There it is.
And that's all there was, is the circumstantial.
Did I tell you about the time I got walked in on by my mom?
No.
Pretty funny. Yeah, like, so...
You might have, but I don't remember.
I was about to take a shower, so I turned the shower on. And then I went back into the room and started making out with my girlfriend. And then, like, locked the door and started having sex. But my mom thought that, like, I, like, passed out in my room. Like on drugs or something, and that's why I left the shower on. So she like freaked out because my door was locked and I wasn't responding. Because like,
you're fucking.
Yeah, because I was fucking. My mom body checks the locked door.
No.
Straight open. Doesn't know I have like my girlfriend over. And I'm just like on top of her, ass towards my mom.
Yeah.
Flip around. Erect penis swings over.
Ejaculate all over your mother.
Peel the blanket from my girlfriend to cover myself.
Uh-huh.
Like a gentleman.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, that happened.
That's fun. Body checked the door open, huh?
Yeah.
Was your mom in the ATF at any point in her life? It's quite the maneuver.
Damn.
How'd the girlfriend feel about that?
Traumatized.
It was a girlfriend, though, right?
Yeah, it wasn't that big of a
deal. A little different than a one-night stand. That'd be something of a cock block if that was the first night you had sex with that girl.
Yeah,
yeah, but it would have been that would have been less awkward because then we wouldn't have to like sit down and
yeah.
be like, hey.
She wouldn't know the lady.
Yeah, it would have just been whatever.
Yeah. Yeah, you had to go have a bowl of grape nuts at 7 a.m. the next morning with your mom and your girlfriend. I'm so sorry again, Sydney. I really thought Austin was on heroin. I thought he was trying to revive himself with a cold shower, man. And then he crawled under his bed to die. I just had no idea.
Croc says that door's locked.
Croc, shoulder check it like Austin's mother. Dino, do you mind grabbing him? So the next day, I didn't even plan on having sex. I thought we were done as far as the penis and pussy was concerned.
Yeah.
We're driving to the outlet mall in Sacramento. We're going to do a little shopping. Mia unzips my pants, unbuttons the fly, starts giving me a roadhead.
Ooh, in the Sable?
No, in my parents' GMC.
Oh.
Big upgrade from the Sable.
Wow.
I think that might have been what did it.
Of course.
There's no way she would have blown me in the Sable.
No way.
That Mercury, or that GMC, though?
Big time blowing.
Moonroof.
Oh, moonroof.
Backup camera.
Backup camera.
The backup camera. Blowjob is an assured thing.
My man. Yeah.
What do you got for me here, Swolby?
I got this plaque that it's a state record of my bench.
I'm going to look it over. I'm going to make sure it's not counterfeit. You two take a seat. Both of you take a seat. No hellos. Nothing off mic.
King Croc.
Have you started saying my man like Leo? Because ever since I started hanging out with Leo, I can't stop saying my man.
It's possible. I'll deny it right now. I don't think I have, but then I'm sure people could timestamp a million times in podcasts where I have.
It sucks. I hate copying my friends.
Yeah, I think he probably stole it from Denzel Washington, an American gangster, though.
What's up, brothers?
After the roadhead, though.
Yeah, in the GMC?
In the GMC. In the General Motors Company vehicle. I started thinking to myself, oh my God, this feels too good.
Too good.
I'm losing control.
No.
My move right now, I certainly can't go home and finish the job in bed. So what do? I pull into a park and ride outside a Sacramento light rail station.
No.
And light rail stations, they are lamps.
They're lit.
They're, you know, moths, how they have attraction to a lamp outside of a house or your garage light?
Yeah.
Junkies are attracted to the Sacramento light rail stations in the same way. So I'm taking a risk here, but I pull her into the corner of the parking lot, the GMC is the her.
Yeah.
I pull down my girlfriend's pants in the back seat.
Uh-huh.
And I fuck her missionary style. Whoa. In one of the captain's chairs in the middle row.
Whoa.
Captain chair.
In the GMC with the moonroof and the backup camera.
Absolutely. So if there was a drone hovering right above us, that would have been problematic.
Captured.
But it ended up being problematic anyway. And not because a junkie spotted us, which is what I expected, but like a 16-year-old mountain biker was watching us.
Watching.
After I withdrew and after she had to get out of the car and piss in a bush because women, I guess, get UTIs.
Yeah, they have to pee after sex.
When they leave the company.
We should too, but we don't.
We don't pee after sex?
I don't.
Speak for yourself, Cigar. I do. Are you circumcised or run? I know that answer.
That,
why did
silly
I ask
question.
That? What I, why did I
what
ask that?
What a silly question.
I'm sorry about that. For people who don't know, Cigar Guy smoked his foreskin famously at a live Leo and Danny show. So yeah, I came in my girlfriend in a captain's chair of a GMC at a light rail station.
Is she on birth control?
No.
Whoa.
Risky business.
It's time for baby Mullen to come into
this world.
Time
to settle down, huh?
she's definitely on birth control.
What a G.
She's definitely on birth control.
So was this 16-year-old mountain biker perched up like a gremlin watching you?
Yeah, like a prairie dog.
Really?
Yeah, not quite as ill-intentioned as a gremlin.
Wow.
But yeah, I mean, after I came, I had some orange juice, I chilled out for a second, and we invited him in for round two.
No!
The game of Thrones. Yeah. It's an underage guy,
get
so
grip,
the statutory
Jack.
Rape isn't that big of a deal. Also, we flew back last night.
Yeah.
And the first time this has ever happened to me, I got the front row on a Southwest.
Oh, how nice is that?
The front row?
So nice.
I felt like I was in first class, even though there isn't first
class.
So
nice, dude. The legroom is fucking ridiculous, dude.
I was snapping at the lady coming down the aisle with the Coca-Colas.
Jesus,
I was scolding people who were trying to use the upfront lavatory.
Wild. And if it crashes, you're going to die the quickest.
Is that true?
Well, dude, if it goes down, boom, you're done. People in the back.
The back of the plane is the safest.
Safest.
Statistically, that's true.
That is true.
That's why they put kids in the back seat.
So I think the most dangerous is on the wings, because if it teeter totters, the wings are filled with fuel, so the wing will scrape and then explode. The back is the safest, and the front, if it's a nosedive, you're done quick.
We usually sit in the back.
Yeah.
When we travel for the Danny Mullen channel, we always go to the back because that's where it's the easiest to find unoccupied rows.
Yeah.
And you can go get your whole squad lined up and fuck around.
But then you might survive and you might lose some legs. You might not even have a face anymore.
Uh-huh.
You might watch all your family die.
Uh-huh.
It's a risky business in the back. And then you got to wait for a while everyone's getting out of the plane.
Mm-hmm. Cigar guy.
Yeah.
Because it sounds like you wouldn't want to go on living if you were maimed physically. True or false?
Yeah.
You would kill yourself if you lost your penis in a plane crash.
Ooh. Do I still have my nuts?
What would you do with your nuts?
Well, I'm thinking here. I'm trying to think. So I got my nuts, but no penis.
You've got nothing.
Nothing.
Sure. For the sake of argument, you have your nuts. Well, are you happy now?
Okay. I have my nuts, but no penis. I think there might be a way for me to get some tube action into the nut so I can still relieve myself into a woman to create spawn.
Okay.
You know
okay.
What I'm saying?
Yeah. I see what you're saying.
I wouldn't kill myself because I got my nuts.
Would you kill yourself after you tubed out the seed from your nuts and got a woman pregnant?
I'd want to be there for my child.
A dickless father.
I'd be a dickless father, but I'd be a father.
You know, anytime you try to discipline your son, you know, Johnny, I think you've been playing PlayStation 7 for far too long tonight. Fuck you, Dad. You don't have a car. When they got to middle school, they'd be real pricks to you.
Oh, fuck. Yeah, I mean, I don't know. I mean, but also you can still, the nuts, the reason, another reason why I asked if I saw the nuts, that's still, you know, you get pleasure from the nuts. You'd still be able to be sexually pleasured.
I don't think so.
Yeah, girl.
You have your asshole. You can still get sexual pleasure from that. Why do you need your nuts?
That's what I'm saying. If I didn't have my nuts, but I still have my asshole, you know, I'm alive.
You still got a prostate.
Ooh, the prostate action.
You would have to find a girl who is satisfied with putting on a strap-on and fucking you up the ass. That would be your sex life.
That's easy.
You know girls like that?
I have known girls like that. Yes.
Have you ever met a girl? I fantasized about this, but not really fantasized. I've just wondered if it exists.
Mm.
I wonder if there are girls out there who only want to get fucked in the ass and couldn't care less about vaginal pleasure.
I have dated women such as that.
Please tell me about the most extreme version of that.
The extreme version of that?
Tell me about the girl who was most diehard ass only.
I had an ex-girlfriend who I was with for quite a bit who preferred that.
Preferred.
Yeah.
To what extent?
To, like, if we're having sex, the vagina is probably not going to be in play.
Would she complain if you fucked her up the puss? That's what
yeah,
I...
Yeah, you know,
that's
she
what
would.
I want.
She would. She would. She didn't like it.
I can see from a mile away that girl got fucked by her stepdad.
You're telling me.
Was that the correct guess there?
100%.
Do you know for a fact?
I'm pretty sure.
Mm-hmm.
I'm pretty sure he was weird.
Cigar guy lived in some sort of commune in Portland. You lived, am I telling the truth? You slept on the floor in a garage that 20 other people, 20 other people lived in the house, and you were in the garage, which is really the bitch spot outside of the cellar.
Well, I wasn't supposed, so we all lived in this this house venue. We'd have shows, some pretty cool bands.
This sounds awful. This sounds like Austin's nightmare.
No, it was great, man. It was great to live in while I was that young. Because I was just drinking, partying until 7 in the morning every morning, going to sleep, waking up. It was great for when I was young.
Mm-hmm.
But then it led that we moved out of that house, and then we moved into another house. They moved into another house. I moved into my own apartment. My fucking mental illness shit started acting up. My anxiety disorder started acting up. So I couldn't afford to rent that apartment anymore because I couldn't work. So I went and...
So anxious you couldn't work, huh?
Yeah, it was really bad. I started to get agoraphobia. I was having panic attacks nonstop.
Did you quit a job you had at the time, or you couldn't apply for
a new
job?
I quit a job.
What job did you have?
I was an after-school art tutor for middle school kids.
Which is about the most laid-back job you could have.
I know, but it's
I can understand if you were a server.
I know, but
you had to approach a table of 20 and start taking orders.
It was a great job, but I didn't want to... I was having so many panic attacks, I didn't want to risk having a panic attack in front of a middle schooler and like having them see that shit.
How dark is a panic attack?
It's sketchy, dude.
What happens during your worst panic attacks?
You start hyperventilating, like, uncontrollably. Your palms get all sweaty. It feels like your throat's closing and you can't catch a breath. It feels like you have a weight on your chest. The room's spinning, literally. Mm-hmm. It feels like there's electricity shooting up from your fucking toes into your head. And you just panic, dude. You literally think you're dying. But now if I have a panic attack, I know what it is. But back then, I had no idea what was fucking happening. I thought I was going crazy. I thought I was dying. So I quit that job.
How much money did you have saved up when you quit that job?
No money. No money.
$200 in your bank
account.
Not
even that. I was living off nothing. I was seriously like I would nothing.
Sure.
It was rock bottom in my life. Mm-hmm. It was the worst as it got.
How many years ago?
This was in 2017.
Recent.
Yeah.
What happens then?
So I move out of that apartment into my friend's house and I sleep in the garage and it's wintertime and it's Portland and it's cold.
How many people
raining.
In that house?
There was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
What's your rent?
8. My rent was, I think it was like $250.
How were you making that?
My dad was helping me out at that point mm-hmm. because I was going through in and out of hospitalizations, like suicide attempts, all kinds of shit.
Sleeping on the floor in a garage probably didn't help.
No, it didn't help, but and it was freezing cold. So at that point, I went into treatment for 4 months for my panic disorder.
And did that involve your drug addiction or drug use too?
Well, so my drug use was me depending on Valium because the panic attacks were so insane.
Yeah.
The anxiety was so insane that even if I wasn't having a panic attack, I felt like I was always going to. So I would take a Valium if I wanted to go get a coffee with my friends. And
did they give you any moves or any mantras to repeat to yourself to calm you down? The reason I'm asking is because I know there are other people in this room who deal with anxiety and thinking too much and having
probably a lot of people watching too.
I don't think I've ever had a full on panic attack, but I've certainly dealt with anxiety. I've had bad weekends, bad weeks where I don't feel good. And I feel like I could use some guidance in getting myself into a more healthy mind frame. So what did they teach you that helped?
Well, a lot. This treatment was really cool. It was inpatient. So I was living in a sober house with some other guys, and the whole thing was, so 5 days a week we would do CrossFit. We'd wake up at 5 a.m. two of the days we would do MMA in the morning. We'd go do MMA and then we'd go do CrossFit until like noon, and then we'd
that helps. Physical exercise helps.
We'd
why exactly
up. It
and why CrossFit?
I gotta remember why exactly, but I know I think it's the endorphins it releases in your body.
Yeah.
And it's just you exhaust yourself physically and mentally by doing so. So when you're not as like taut, you're not ready to go with a panic attack.
And you probably also have a degree of self-esteem because you got up early
you
and worked out.
That's the biggest thing, because you wake up early, you have to make your bed.
Yeah.
You have to eat breakfast.
Yeah.
You go do the MMA, you're exhausted, but you don't give up.
So
and then you go to CrossFit.
That's a couple of things you've done already. You've woke up early, you've made your bed, you've ate healthy, and you've worked out. So you have 4 things checked off your list before 9 a.m.
Exactly.
And it's hard to feel bad about yourself.
That's exactly it.
When you're doing that kind of shit early in the morning.
Yeah. And then the rest of the day is talking to a therapist for a couple hours.
Sure.
And then you go home at like 3, and then you just socialize with your housemates, and then you cook dinner. You're completely
being social.
It turned me from a child into an adult.
Yeah.
Because beforehand, like I said, I was staying up until 7:30, 8 in the morning, drinking, partying, you know, not giving a shit. And then I'm waking up at 5 a.m. and doing all this stuff. And so I did that, and it helped my panic disorder a lot.
Yep.
And then I got on Lexapro, and that really helped. And then I got into a long-term relationship. That ended. Now I'm here, and I'm doing better than ever, I think. Mm-hmm. But I do want anyone watching to know, because when I was in that cold garage having those panic attacks, I literally felt like my life was over, and I was contemplating suicide.
And now you're at live podcast smoking your own foreskin.
Yeah, exactly, dude. I'm literally, there's been so many times in my life where wanted to kill myself, and then I decide, and then I look back, and I'm so grateful I didn't. So if anyone's out there dealing with that stuff, just, you know, do all the, you know, do the stuff, like wake up early, work out, and it changes your fucking life. And I know you do all that stuff too, man. You started going to bed earlier. You don't drink. You know? And it's seriously.
Yeah. Listen, life is hard enough on 8 hours of sleep with a healthy diet.
It's crazy, man.
And so you don't need to add into the mix, at least not on a regular basis, hangovers, whether they be from drugs or cocaine. Yeah. You don't need to add in a fucking 4 hour night of sleep.
Yep,
you don't need to add in 4 Big Macs and a Famous Star for your meal that day.
Exactly, man.
All of that shit is going to make it harder for you to be happy and productive.
Yeah, and read too. Reading is insane.
Yeah.
I love it. And there's so many good books out there that just completely change how you view life and yourself.
Yeah,
and it's so important.
Like for me, when I first read The Secret, I felt changed.
Yeah.
For Austin, when he first read Mein Kampf, he felt changed. I actually read on the plane yesterday, and this really helped me too, that a lot of your mood, most of your mood, I can't give an exact percentage because I don't read very carefully, is dictated not by what's going on up here in your brain. It's actually dictated by how your body is moving.
Yeah.
So there's been a study that if you put a pencil in your teeth and you clamp it like this, you're stimulating the same muscles that you would if you were smiling, and people reported being more happy.
Yeah.
And scans can show that more of the happiness chemical and areas of activity in the brain are being triggered when the muscles are engaged that indicate smiling. If you're feeling depressed, not confident, sad, all you have to do is bring your shoulders back, stand up straight, smile, put your hands on your hips.
Yeah.
Assume a posture of confidence. Assume a posture of contentment.
Yeah.
And you will start to feel confident and content.
That's right. It's nuts.
It's crazy.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck.
And let's move on to our esteemed guests over here.
Here we go.
Certificate of Achievement, says this placard that Swolby gave me.
Swolby.
The certificate is presented to Melvin Caballero.
Woo!
Did I say that right?
No.
Caballero.
There you go. Yeah.
That's a cool last name. It's in weird cursive.
Caballero?
The lifter named above set a state drug tested record as recognized by the United States Powerlifting Association. On behalf of the USPA, congratulations on your achievement. You've set a drug testing record?
A drug tested. So like, I'm not on trend. I'm not on like Anavar right now.
Oh,
I'm
so,
like,
okay,
completely natty.
So they're clarifying that because there's other records that go to people that aren't drug tested.
Yeah, I piss in a cup.
Nice.
Certified
pimpage.
Is that state as in like, it's not like college state, it's just like state record?
Not like California state.
Wait, I'm confused. Wow. So this doesn't prove you won anything as far as lifting is concerned. It just proves you're not on steroids.
You broke the record.
I broke the California bench record in that.
Oh. Where does it say that?
It's in the middle. It says bench and it says the number.
So for your weight, you bench the highest than anyone in all.
Okay, asshole,
ever.
You didn't frame it well enough. Bench is cut off.
The paper was too large.
So he can. All I'm reading is the drug testing shit. Over here it says bench. You can see it's pretty much invisible.
Oh, man.
I kind of fucked up.
Why is it cut off
printing,
like down the bottom?
I didn't have any color print either, so I just did it in black and white.
You gotta go to Kinko's for something that important.
Dude, they need to forget weight, forget your drug status enough. For you, a bench press, the bar only has to cover 3 vertical inches.
That's right.
You have arms like a Teletubby. It doesn't count.
Oh, shit. I mean, it is what it is. Like, some people can't even move it an inch. Like, if they had it on their hand, it would just fold them flat or, like, cave their chest in. You know what I mean?
Jesus.
It's just like, when I started, I couldn't even do 2 plates. I started at like 1.
This would be like a fat guy being really good at the luge and breaking a bunch of records. No shit. Okay? He's heavier. There's more
blubber.
I think Newton proved that weight doesn't matter when it comes to gravity. Doesn't matter.
Really?
All right? It's still bullshit. He dropped an apple in a vacuum.
Oh,
a bowling ball would fall at the same speed.
Shit. Wild, dude. Build more inertia, though.
Down
so
a slide.
Swolby's got inertia.
Yeah,
speed.
Hell yeah, Jack.
Speed.
That's wicked.
Force equals mass times velocity.
Okay, Austin is trying to get this. No, he doesn't want the microphone. He wants the thing you're smoking. Swolby's passing it over. Is that weed or tobacco?
Tobacco. No,
it's not tobacco. It's an e-cig.
It's actually an e-cig.
King Croc, how was your first day at work?
It was actually great, man, despite having a
rough week.
Rough week.
Big Crocs, big weekend, dude.
It was kind of nice, though.
Let's start at the weekend. I think that's going to be a lot more interesting than your first day at work.
All right, buddy.
What's been going on, King?
Not much, man. What do? We, you know, saw some ladies.
So it started off like this. Friday, they came and visited me at the... Or no, Saturday, they came and visited me at the Cigar Lounge.
Who's they?
Swolby and Croc here.
I got to come by the Cigar Lounge. Just turning into the Seinfeld coffee shop.
Yeah, it's nice,
it actually
man.
Is. Croc comedians got some, keep coming in and stuff.
He got some good networking done. He met a importer-exporter. He got his business card.
No, you met George Costanza.
Yeah, exactly.
That's a joke, right? Know, or did he actually... Okay.
Yeah, he wants to be... He was an architect and an importer-exporter.
It's not a joke.
It's not...
This is real.
Legit. No. It actually was real, but yeah, the George Costanza thing is a joke. But anyway, we were there, and then we decided we were going to go out and close some deals. We're going to go...
get some pussy.
Get some leads. Some cold leads.
I got a video. I would love to have this played on screen. Maybe, yeah. Austin, we could put it in the edit. Cigar guy shoots me a text, and it's a video of King Croc making a move on a Target employee.
Okay, yeah. He said it's
a video. Yeah. Austin, do you like the sound of that? I'm going to text it to Austin right now.
Yeah, so that was, we went into the Target. As we're walking in, he immediately darts to a Russian, I would say a MILF, right?
Yeah, she was a MILF.
Her name was what?
Svetlana.
Svetlana. And so he takes Svetlana into a dark corner, and me and Swolby have just kept walking on, and we go back and we can see them in the reflection.
Uh-huh.
And King Croc is working his game, baby.
But what was his opening line?
I don't know. Let's find out.
I have a wild guess I can throw out.
What was it?
Hey, can I meet you real quick?
Classic line.
All right, Austin, I'm hitting you with a video of King Croc in the wild making moves right now.
And so he gets the Svetlana girl's number, but she has a husband.
Just a second. I have to announce right now, we were talking about my weekend at home with my girlfriend. My girlfriend asked for my mom's phone number, which I don't know what that was all about, really. But I just got a text from a group text of my girlfriend and my mom. And my mom is notorious for having too much time on her hands.
Oh, no.
And sending way too many links and videos off YouTube from 2006 that aren't even a little bit funny. Man. So I got to have a talk with my girlfriend that we need to extricate ourselves from this group chat.
That's fucking classic, dude.
Did you get that video I just sent, Austin?
Yeah, I was going to add it in post.
Why didn't you stop me? I was hearing a story about Svetlana or some sort of hooker giving somebody a lap dance, but I couldn't pay attention because I was sending you the file.
I'm sorry. I said I'll edit it in. My phone's dead.
You were too busy. It's dead?
Email me.
Fuck you. King Croc, continue. Whoever was talking, continue.
Yeah, he gets Svetlana's number, and then we go into Target, and then as we're walking towards my ATM so I can deposit some money, he sees
in
a...
In Target?
We're in Target.
Bank in Target?
Yeah, Capital One.
It's in Target?
Yeah, the Capital One ATM. The bank was closed. I had to go to the ATM.
And it's inside the red and the white.
The most closest one was inside of the Target. Yeah. But
interesting.
As we're going there...
Yeah.
You see a woman buy some a shelf of wine. And what do you say to this woman by the shelf of wine?
There were a lot of different women that day.
This is the second one.
The second one.
We're walking in. She's by the wine. He says, "Hey, can I ask you a question real quick?"
Oh.
And you said, and she said, "Yeah, what?
Swolby, why do you have the mic?"
Because I remember what he said.
What did he say?
He said, "Do you know any good alcoholic beverages?"
Yeah, I did, dude.
He doesn't even go off being in the wine aisle. He takes a step back and asks about alcoholic beverages.
Yeah.
She says, "No, I don't drink." And his second question was, "Are you underage?"
No, that was a little bit later on. That was in the aisle.
When he talks to the employee.
Because he had learned his lesson about asking if she's underage or not.
What's the lesson there, King Croc? Don't ask, just fuck.
No.
Because as I'm depositing my money into the ATM, he starts hitting on a Target employee.
So I'm trying to picture this. I imagine you just beelined it to the ATM. You've probably been inside for about a minute and 10 seconds
at this
point.
He's already striking three women.
That's a go, dude. I have to just open leads, bro.
Yeah, numbers game. So you ask the girl in the wine aisle if she knows anything about alcohol.
Yeah, and then she's like, "No." And then I'm like, "Are you underage?" I'm like, I think it was two girls. Wasn't it two girls? Something like that.
Well, right now we're talking about the one while I'm depositing ATM that we have on video. The Target employee.
Oh, the employee, the girl. Okay. So I'm like, I forgot, dude.
Oh, man.
I forgot the details.
Good thing we have Swolby here to remember him.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
So he hits her. He's like, I have a question. He asks about an item like, oh, where can I find this? And then she starts talking. And I immediately, my immediate instinct was to record this because I knew it was going to be fucking great.
Yeah.
I got to know what item he asked about.
What did you ask about?
Magnum condoms.
I forgot.
Dude, he was a mask. So he was looking for a mask for Cigar Guy.
Oh, yeah.
We're trying to get him a mask. And
why would a random girl in Target know where the masks were kept?
Yeah.
And this chick was working at guest services, so.
She was an employee, though.
Yeah.
I misunderstood. I thought she was a random customer.
No, this is the employee that we have on video.
Sure.
Oh, sorry. Yeah.
And so I record, and then I don't know what the dialogue was because the guy just comes in and he asked me, like, oh, what are you guys doing? I was like, oh, Cigar Guys, I'm withdrawing some cash.
Yeah.
So I just keep the camera rolling. I look.
Is it a camera or your phone?
My phone.
And you got caught filming with your phone?
Yeah.
Yeah. But I kept.
How do you get caught filming with your phone? It's the easiest thing to disguise.
I was like this, and like my phone has a sticker on it, so you could see it's a phone. But I said, fuck it. You know, I kept recording, and then I just hear, I hear Croc say, are you under the age of 18? And then
is that the second time he used that line?
Yeah. Yeah.
Why'd you make that face?
King Croc, who fed you that one? Yeah. Who taught you that move?
You sounded like a porn website. Like, yeah. Are you under the age of 18?
And then after this one, immediately after, we go to look for, what were we looking for? We're looking for beer. They wanted some beer.
Oh, yeah.
And then King Croc parts ways from us, and we're like, where the fuck is he going? And we go into the aisle, and he's talking to these two ladies. And one of them 16, it turned out.
Yeah, yeah. No, honestly, I don't want to say this. No,
say it.
Danny, don't give me that face, dude. You gave me the face like...
My face is moving involuntarily. I'm engaged in the story.
Okay.
I'm not passing judgment on you, King.
Okay, all right, thanks. It makes me feel better.
It's important to note that every time, as soon as Croc found out they were underage, he drifted away into the wind.
Dude, what move I told you I did?
You stepped off the line, bro.
Bro, I step off the line, bro.
Are you going after chicks in the toy section, though?
No.
Why do you have to ask if they're 16 every single time?
And then he approached a Latina mom with her, like, 3-year-old daughter walking next to her. And
he got down on one knee.
And she ignored him completely, and you started speaking Spanish to her.
Hola. ¿Qué pasó, chica?
Yeah.
I had to... She didn't want to do it, though. She had a little Bobby with her. I said, okay.
So you went down in flames 5 times in Target.
Oh, yeah. Maybe 7, 8. On the way walking CVS, we're going to Target. How many times? Like,
well, on our way back to the car, we're all walking on this dark road, and there's 3 girls in front of us.
Oh, yeah.
And perfect time to approach.
And then he starts screaming from behind them. What
perfect.
Did you say?
Okay. But Danny, here's the thing.
Yeah.
If I don't approach,
mm-hmm.
my chance is 0%.
Yeah.
But I look at it like these leads, I'm never going to see them again.
Yeah.
Okay, we're on a dark street in the middle of the night. We're 3 gigantic dudes. They're 3 young women.
Swolby's gigantic?
He's huge. He's swollen.
He's pretty huge.
Pretty fucking wide.
Yeah. I've seen that YouTube video without his cock blurred, so don't give me that shit. I don't have a big cock either. I don't have a...
But no, Croc, you don't yell at women in a dark street in your deep black voice.
Hey, yo, what's up? Hey, can we talk to you real quick?
Oh, it scared me just hearing it.
I did.
And they
me
and
too.
They looked back real
You're
quick.
You're going to give them a panic
started,
attack.
They started speed walking away. And he kept going. And I was like,
honestly,
Croc,
Danny,
shut up.
I'm going to open up to you right now.
Yeah.
I've really, you know, a part of my personality, I feel like, has blossomed recently. Even just, you know.
If only we could say the same for your game, though.
No. That's a part of it. I think... I'm the kind of guy, because I was a security guard, man.
Mm-hmm.
I came here really about being a security guard, and I told Leo that, and I told you that.
Mm-hmm.
And I asked Leo, how can I be better? How serious you want me to take this? You're putting me in all these videos.
Yeah.
I was already around tough guys, and my nature is very direct. I can be aggressive,
yeah,
without trying to be. And so when you add that on top of my sexual nature, I think some girls just can't take it. You got a lot of sluts can take it. Oof. But if they're not a slut, they probably don't like it. I get it.
So you're narrowing down your marriage prospects to only sluts.
No.
Is that what you're telling me?
No. That's not what I'm saying. I'm just saying.
Isn't it time to dial it back a bit then?
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. I'm going to dial it back because now I know something about myself, like how I'm perceived by others. It's like, oh, you know. But, you know, that's because I'm a genius. So I put the two.
Of course. You're humble too.
Yeah.
You're the king crocodile. King Croc. Do you think you're getting any better with women?
I think so, yeah. I just don't have the volume right now.
Sounds like your volume is not the problem.
No, I mean,
it's you put up prodigious numbers in that target.
I did put up big numbers.
Huge.
Big numbers. Yeah. Sounds like volume isn't even close to the... You put up big numbers in Yosemite. You probably put up big numbers on the walk from here to your car. My neighbor lady hasn't been talking to me since you started coming around. Oh my gosh.
He's 4-32 from this weekend.
What are the four? Is that getting a number?
Getting a number.
Is that considered a victory?
That's getting a lead.
I mean, we're going to see what comes out of the funnel.
Give him the mic. Swoops.
We're going to see what comes out of the funnel at the end, but I had four yesterday, dude.
You got four phone numbers.
Leads. Or I don't know if it was yesterday or yesterday.
No, that was 2 days ago. Yesterday was when we went to, on your second big night out.
Okay.
Let's hear about this. So did we miss anything from the strip club? Did anything funny happen there?
The strip club?
We were talking about Svetlana, right? Was she a stripper?
No,
I'm sorry.
This was
a
target.
I had to send the video and I was distracted.
We haven't started talking about the strip club yet.
Let me tell him about Svetlana real quick.
Let's hear it.
Svetlana, right?
This was the lady who he encountered as we were walking into the Target.
We park in the CVS parking lot, high IQ. We're not paying for parking. We fucking get out the car. We start strolling. I'm stepping. We're kicking. Next thing you know, blonde. Double D's.
She was brunette.
Big tits?
No, she was blonde.
Was she a brunette with A cups?
No.
Just the opposite of how you described.
She was blonde. She was a blonde Russian girl.
She was a brunette.
Uh-huh. No, bullshit. Okay, listen. So she turns the corner, boom, right? Instantly,
what?
Can I meet you real quick? But guess what? My game.
It's the King Croc Terminator noise. That's how he zeroes in on the prospect. Beer.
Here's how I switched it up on him. I don't put the hand no more.
Oh,
I've evolved my game. I keep it in the pocket.
Oof.
I don't fist bump once in a while, but
you keep it in your, they probably think you have a knife.
Yeah, all right, because I'm black, Danny.
Keep your hand on your
because
side.
Because you have your hand suspiciously holstered in your pocket.
No, but I'm just saying.
And yes, because you approach girls in parking lots after dark. And you have your hand tucked into your sweatshirt pocket.
You know what it is? It's because I believe.
Trayvon Martin got killed for less.
For less? I know. Much less. But it's because I truly internally understand how good I am and kind I am and, you know. Superior to the masses. No, I'm just kidding. But these are the ways that I believe in myself. So I assume no one will perceive me in that way. So I just go about my life.
This is the thing, King Croc. Right now, that philosophy would be like, if I adopted the same thing, I'd be like, I'm such a good podcaster. I'm so funny. I don't even need to talk into my microphone during podcast. I'm going to be John Cage and give the people 2 hours of silence just because I believe in myself. You see how somebody once said, in one of my classes in college, I know all the material, but I just don't feel like taking tests. I don't test well. I shouldn't have to take a test. And the professor said to this girl, well, you understand tests, the point is to prove your knowledge. And there's no proof of your knowledge unless you take the test. Yeah. At some point, the rubber's got to meet the road and you got to prove to these women that you're not going to stab them.
Right. Right, and that's what I'm working. That's why I took the handshake.
He's working on proving he's not going to stab him.
Yeah, and I remove the handshake, so I just go, hey, can I meet you real quick? I lean in a little bit with the torso, a little bit.
Oh, no.
A little bit.
Why?
Just so they know I'm talking to him, right? And then she stops, blah, 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 hit her, a comedian, blah, blah, hit her. She's like, I have a husband.
Well,
that's fine.
Wait.
I'm just inviting you to a comedy show.
You told her you were a comedian?
Yeah.
What's going to happen when she inquires about the show and she actually shows up?
It's not going to be a show. My text is going to be, do you like red or white wine? If she responds, boom.
Uh-huh.
He said, if she asked, where's the comedy show? He said, it's going to be in it my bedroom.
Yeah, that's what he did say. He did say that.
And
the comedy show is going to start when he pulls his pants down.
Yeah. Oh, guess what? Guess what, Danny? Guess what, Danny?
What?
The BBC is truly being revealed.
What does that mean?
I am losing so much groin fat, you would not believe it. I mean, oh my gosh.
King Croc, stand up and let me see your stomach right now. You say so much as if it's coming off in torrents. Can we get a camera on that? Dino, you're on it?
Yeah, I got it.
Damn, G.
How much weight have you lost? Supposedly lost.
I'm at 249 right now.
What'd you used to be at? Yeah, can we mic him, Swolps?
I'm at 249 currently, and I used to be 325.
Wow.
When were you? How much did you weigh when you met me?
286.
Wow.
Okay. Okay.
I told you I'm a trooper, man. I don't just talk out the mouth, man.
Yeah.
I don't just talk out the mouth. And that's what I love about when you go through hardship, when your life is so fucked, you have to go through the pain, and so you become better. And all I'm saying is, like, when I run my mouth, I have to actually go get tested in the streets. If I talk a certain way, I actually have to back it up. I actually, like, will get fucked up, you know, in different ways. So I can't. And anytime I say something, now the whole world is watching. So I got to do it.
I wish my cock is watching. Coming out. I'd be a lot richer if the whole world is watching this.
Danny Mullen, I'm saying it now. Danny Mullen, my cock's coming out. And the world is going to see the cock.
The way things. And I was also, that was a generic small dick joke I was unleashing. I know you don't have a small dick, King Croc. Okay. But I know there's also something to be said for the weight gain stealing inches from your hog. Because I saw Mudflap's penis, and Mudflap says he's lost about 3 inches on his penis, which has got to be damn near half of that thing.
Wow.
And I saw it because I saw his penis in the antique shop in Bishop. It was in this week's main channel video. And you know what it looks like? It's when you go snowboarding and there are those cone-shaped holes around the bases of pine trees, and then the snow builds up all around the tree, but there's still... It looked like that. He, Mudflap, had to push down on either side of his penis, and his pelvis became like a penis dispenser. As he pushed the fat aside, the cock shot out more, like cheese whiz
like
out of a tube.
Is it?
Like sort of, yeah. Yeah, it gets sucked into the fat like a pine tree gets sucked into the snowfall when you're snowboarding.
That is the most vicious.
And sometimes you, when you're in that condition, sometimes you piss on your balls. Just on accident.
Brutal.
You're not even trying to piss on your balls. It just dribbles in.
Jesus,
dude. I've been that obese. I've been there.
I feel for you, buddy. Well, yeah. King Croc, let's hear about your second night.
So we start off
in my
backyard. We're smoking cigarettes. He's drinking beer. We decided to do an Instagram live stream.
I got to come to the Cigar Guy's house. I got to check this place out.
You got to check it out.
Chill, dude. It's fucking chill.
His cat is fucking
cool. Yeah, I got a cool fat cat. They met the obese cat.
Love it.
So yeah, we're hanging out there. We do a live stream on Instagram, which then makes it so Swolby comes, and we're here. You take it away. I want to hear what you have to say.
Okay, so we're doing our shit. How much do we want to talk about it? How much?
It's up to you, King Croc.
Okay.
There's some juicy information coming up here.
No. So basically, you know, we're kicking it. We decide, fuck, let's go see a porno. I don't know why.
Let's go see a porno?
No, we don't decide that.
We decided that.
I had walked by this porn theater the other day. It's the Chinese theater for porn.
Wow.
John Holmes' handprints are on the front.
Wow.
It's where Deep Throat premiered. So we decided to go check it out because we think it'd be really funny to see how King Croc acts in that environment.
Yeah.
And then, so go ahead, take it.
Show up.
A porn theater. What a dinosaur that is.
I think it's the last one.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know.
And we wondered what we'd find, what kind of people there. Like,
what kind of leads.
You know, what's going on?
It's a good opportunity for networking, I'm sure, King Croc.
I was just seeing what's going on, and we slide in. And
so who's all there, King Croc?
It's a lot of booty warriors.
Well, just tell me who's there.
Gay people.
No, like who went in our group there?
Gay people. Why were there gay people there?
Oh, Swolby.
Yeah.
Who else?
Yeah, like, well, who was it? I just want to know.
I mean, it was just a girl. What?
I'm trying to figure out how I should tell the story, Croc.
Okay, it was a fucking girl, dude.
Okay, so it was Swolby, me, Croc, and a girl.
Sure.
Two girls.
Two girls.
Oh, yeah, two girls.
Okay.
And then, so we go into the porn theater, and immediately to our left as we're walking into the darkness. Well, first, yeah, as we walk into the darkness, there is a man having sex with another man.
In the theater?
In the theater.
What was playing on screen?
Like Resident Evil. They weren't even playing porn because of COVID guidelines.
Yep. It wasn't even porn.
Did you guys buy a ticket to go see Resident Evil, the porn theater?
No, we bought $20 to go see the movie that they were playing. They didn't even tell us what movie it was.
I paid for crap.
And you get in there and it's just a regular film.
Yeah, it's just a regular film. There's two guys having sex to our left.
Yeah.
We immediately go down.
I guess that's what you're paying for, is the chance of that might happen.
Yeah, they're probably paying
us. Pee-wee Herman might be in there in a trench coat.
Yeah, exactly, bro. Yeah. So we immediately dart to the front trying to find a safe area because we just encountered something evil.
I'm impressed you guys didn't turn on your heels and leave. Austin, what would you have done if you walked into that theater?
And saw the gay guys having sex?
Yeah.
I would have been out of there.
Me too.
I would have already left.
And I'm not a prude.
We couldn't have turned because we would have had to... So we just darted in and then we see a hut, like a tent, in the theater. And we turn into the tent. It's pitch black. Our eyes haven't adjusted yet. It's like a haunted house.
Sure.
And it smells in there. What does it smell like?
Fucking straight jizz.
Smells like jizz. Jizz and piss.
Like if you took a wad of toilet paper you just jerked off into and used it as a chloroform room.
Yeah. So we go in there and we're standing there. We're trying to make a game plan. We're huddled like we're about to play a football game. These gay guys keep coming in and peeking into the hut. Like they're looking to see if we're doing anything.
You guys are in the hut?
We're in the hut. We took shelter in the hut.
Jizz hut.
It turned out to be a jizz hut. And then so we decided to get out of there.
Who do you think they wanted the fuck out of you guys?
Croc.
No, cut it out. They couldn't even see me.
We don't want to kill a street cred here. I get it.
So we decide, all right, we're going to go sit down and then gather enough courage to walk past the gay people to get out of here who are having sex. There's nothing wrong with gay people, but they're having sex. They're naked.
And they're very sexually aggressive. That's no secret.
Yeah.
There is a kind of person who is going to try to rape you, mm-hmm. It's a guy who's fucking in a porn theater on a Saturday night.
Yep.
Or was it Sunday night?
It was Sunday night, last night.
They don't even have gods. That's what
exactly.
That means. Exactly.
But
fucking
it was
on Sunday.
Redeemed. The story gets redeemed.
Yeah, it does. At one, some point.
Yeah, because right now the story makes it seem like you're gay, King.
Yeah. So we're sitting there in the seats. We're trying to figure out how we should leave. And then we see two people go into the hut. And then Swolby is brave enough to go peek into the hut to see what is happening. What do you see, Swolby?
No one wanted to go see, so I was like, hey, I'm going to take one for the team, and I'm going to see what's going on here. And I see this guy fully fucking butt naked, and just a black dude just blowing him in the fucking jizz hut.
Oh, I didn't know it was a black dude.
And I just turned around. I turned around real quick. I was like,
he turned around real quick in front of everybody in the theater and ran back to the seat.
It was fucked up.
So
So
Resident Evil's playing, and a bunch of gay guys are just fucking.
Yeah, and we're sitting there, and then Swolby turned.
Was there no security?
No. Nope. Swolby leans over to me and Croc and says, don't look behind you.
This is just a bathhouse you guys went into.
Yeah, we found out. And then, and so we decide to get up and leave. And then there's probably about four gay couples butt naked just going at right next to the entrance.
I tell them, I whisper to everybody. That's,
oh, yeah.
It's like, do not, whatever you do, do not look back.
Yeah.
Because there's some fucked up shit going on behind us.
Uh-huh.
And, what I seen was a guy fucking another guy in the ass, and he was fully naked in the back of the theater.
Yeah.
Just railing him, just pounding him.
Okay, somebody answer this question who's not King Croc, so I know he won't give me a real answer. But were any of these guys good looking?
It was too dark.
Were any of these guys... This is why I'm asking.
They were wearing masks, I don't know.
COVID masks.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
I didn't know if they were wearing GIMP masks or something. But
that's
it's just
the state we live in. You have to wear a mask, but you can fuck each other.
Yeah. You can get AIDS as long as you're not contracting COVID. You have the right to get AIDS. But it's just like, I'm trying to think, if this were an option for straight people to just go to some seedy theater on Hollywood Boulevard and fuck chicks.
Wow.
I would not take that if... This okay, if it were just pussy juice and shit and blood all over the place, these girls, I don't think they could be hot enough for me to go in there and still be down to fuck them.
Yeah, it's like an STD haven, man.
There's no way.
It's just, it's insane how I get why gay guys want to fuck all the time. Because it's always there, it's always available. We, when we want sex or pleasure, we have to jerk off. They can go out and do something about it. But it seems like I wouldn't want to do something about it. I would rather jerk off than hail an Uber to the Chinese theater for porn and get fucked in a cum hut. Like, I would rather stay home, jerk off, and eat a bowl of cereal.
I don't understand how they're not scared of contracting, you know, STDs with just, like, I mean, you know
Yeah, I mean, I get why the biggest fear for straight people, I feel like, is getting a girl pregnant.
Yeah.
For us, that's the biggest fucking fear.
For guys, it's...
We don't have AIDS, but there are pills now that prevent the spread of AIDS.
Yeah, there is.
So I guess I get why they're a little more cavalier. Then again, they've been fucking
straight
cavalier
the whole
time.
Straight people can get AIDS, too, but it's more prevalent in the gay community because of places like this porn theater.
Yeah, straight people can get AIDS, but it's super rare. It's probably because they're sharing a needle.
Yeah.
Were there no women 1%. At all?
Besides the two we were with.
Oh, yeah, y'all brought two chicks?
Yeah.
I completely forgot there were two girls.
Yeah. Yeah. We said it's for a bit.
Yeah. Because originally we were going to get a bit where Croc goes in there and tries to network with people.
Yeah.
Watching porn. We thought that'd be funny to bring on the podcast.
I love it. It's fucking great. Yeah. You guys have done well.
Yeah.
It's too bad we couldn't film something like that for YouTube. It would just have to be so heavily censored.
I know. It'd be so censored, man. Like, I'm a dark guy.
So, Kink, well, you're dark, but you have impeccable taste in where to take women for dates, clearly.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
And so, we decide to part ways. So Swolby parts ways with us, and the two girls parts ways with us, and then me and Croc go to Seventh Vale on Sunset.
Tell me about Seventh Vale.
What is that, Croc?
It was nice.
Do that move again. Yeah. This is what King Croc did.
It was Croc's first strip club, and I had to pay for him to get in. And then I gave
him... How much?
$20 for his entrance fee, and then I gave him, what did you say, like $20 of singles?
Yeah, he gave me like 20 in singles, maybe 25.
And I had to teach him the etiquette.
What's the point of giving him 20 in singles? Because going up to the rail and throwing ones, that's just a waste of money.
Well,
you get the same experience setting three rows back.
That's what you think, but there's this one girl there who was incredibly vicious, and she broke my nose with her breast.
She was hardcore.
Big tits? No, they were okay, but she took my head and slammed it into her jugs. It ripped my nose piercing. And then she went to Croc next and gave him a black eye with her nipple on.
Dude, she rubbed that nipple all in my eye,
I would have paid $20 to avoid that.
I know.
Why is that exciting?
We stepped away after that. We didn't know it was going to happen.
Here's the thing, dude. I love strippers.
He loved it, dude.
I love, like, honestly, they are masters of their art. I think, like, they know exactly what to do. Like,
doing pills and having their boyfriends fuck them up.
He got so horny towards the end of it that he couldn't even wait while we were about to go to IHOP to close out the night. He had to go into the bathroom of the strip club to jerk off because he couldn't handle it.
King Croc. Is that true?
It's true, but I left it halfway. And my hog was looking nice. I'm getting more and more proud of my hog every day, dude.
You can't be proud when you're masturbating in a strip club bathroom.
Y'all too broke to do anything.
I don't care if it's 10 inches.
Yeah.
You can't be, dude. That's as low as it gets.
But, dude.
King Croc, we talked about this recently. I forget which podcast it was on. I used to do shit like that when I was in seventh grade and we'd managed to download some porn off LimeWire. There's no excuse for you as an employed adult to have to slip off and masturbate in a bathroom.
He's looking out for his health. He doesn't want to get blue balls.
Blue balls is a serious medical issue.
It's bad.
He told me he had already ejaculated in his pants and then he went to go uncontrollably.
The pre-cum came first because the Latina, and then the blonde one with the tattoos, she walked by. Pre-cum, boom.
You came when a girl walked.
I didn't pre-cum. No, pre-cum because you know they're charming you, right?
One of them tried to charm you, and you said you couldn't speak English because you thought she was ugly.
Yo, here's the craziest part. She was Asian. I love Asian girls, but she had a long face, and a long ass.
Long ass.
No, but not in a derogatory way.
You were ignoring her.
Yeah, no, I said I couldn't speak English.
You said no inglés, like you're fucking Mexican.
She was trying to get me. But then another one came. She was really nice to me. She freaking was talking to me. And she was really just helping, working through my emotions with me. So, you know.
What emotions were you feeling?
I was just feeling bad, just like just heartbroken because so many leads just been just going cold, like, you know,
yeah,
going cold on me, you know. But
how many leads you figure have gone cold on you recently?
14, 15.
Those numbers will bring grief to anybody.
How many leads have become warmer?
Not even one.
Oh.
Can you? Is it possible, King Croc, to microwave a lead after it goes cold? Can you reheat that shit?
Bro, literally, I had a girl hit me up 3 months later. She ghosted me, hit me up 3 months later.
And talking after, to the mic, bro.
After one day of talking to me, she ghosted me again. What?
Oh, read the text. Wrong. Read the text you sent the girl who ghosted you that you showed me.
Oh, this will be good.
Which one?
The one. Here, show Danny that
lead
whole
number
thread.
Nine. Let's pull that up.
This shit's so funny.
King Croc, are you okay with showing this?
Yeah, I'm totally fine.
It's funny, but I don't want.
She's dead to me.
Sure.
No, I'm dead to her, honestly. But
let's just hope she's not literally dead.
Yeah. No.
King Croc, what do the ladies think of your suit jacket with hoodie? Yeah.
Well, he just came from work.
Yeah, I just came from work. And also, I asked a lady in a car wash if I looked homeless, and she said no.
You don't look homeless.
Yeah, because I'm always worried about that when I wear this shit. But
I'm glad you picked this outfit for your first day of work then.
Yeah.
An outfit you worry about being mistaken for a homeless person in.
So, I hit her with the, what you doing this weekend? No response.
Can I please reenact this?
Yeah, go ahead.
Thank
go
you.
Ahead,
Manny. Thank you.
Oh, this is so
funny. All right, King Croc, you're giving me permission to read this?
Yeah, go ahead, dude.
WYD this weekend. No response. King Croc rallies back with a, hey, Valerie.
How long in between texts?
That is, let me get a date on this first one. April 27th, April 29th. Just 2 days. Not
oh,
too
nice.
Bad. Did you send the cat emoji?
Yeah, I did.
It's a cat gif of a cat looking at a water faucet. What the fuck is that supposed to mean, King Croc?
Cheer her up a little bit. Maybe she'll text me back.
And this is King Croc. And the award for best texter goes to period, 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 period. I genuinely didn't take you to be this kind of girl, says King Croc.
Hey man, I had to play my cards, bro. What do you want me to do?
What kind of girl do you mean? A girl who's exercising free will?
No.
You realize women have the right to not text any of us back.
Yeah, no, that's totally fine. But I have.
And why'd you tell this girl your real name? You're King Croc.
Should I tell all?
They might assume you're somebody if you just go by King Croc.
Yeah. He doesn't go by Croc with women.
He changed the name. He has
an alter ego.
He introduces himself as Dio now.
Dio, dude. He says it's Leo but with a D. That won't freak him
out. King Croc, what's this all about?
You know, I thought it'd be better to get some distance between me and, you know,
just go
leads and
just go by KC. How about that? Just King
dude,
Croc.
KC is cool, bro. KC is cool.
Wait, please break down the logic for you going by Dio. I'm sorry I interrupted you.
Okay. Honestly, the logic was, so on Tinder, I'm just keeping 100, man. On Tinder, right, after you make a certain amount of profiles, you got to start changing up the names because the girls see the same name on different Tinder profiles.
Why do you have more than one profile?
Because for the algorithm, you know, when...
That's not what the algorithm wants you to do.
Yeah, no. Well, that's what I want the algorithm to do. I want to get more leads. So I go in and I... you know, change up my name and I just swipe a bunch. I run out of swipes, go on my next Tinder account. I might slide in Baidu, but that's lower class girls, of course. But
Baidu?
You never heard of that?
What does that mean?
It's a dating app.
Baidu is ghetto black girls from South Central.
I didn't say they're ghetto girls from everywhere.
Sure.
Wow. Yeah.
No, but yeah, so I was just, you know.
How many aliases are you juggling?
Darren, Dio, D-I-O-D-O.
Came in
I don't
hot,
know if
dude.
I want to give up any more of them.
I can assure you none of the girls who are potentially going to date you are listening.
All right, Darren spelled differently.
King Croc spelled with a C. Yeah. And then Croc spelled with a K.
Yeah, and then Dio Steel. That's one of my...
Dio Steel?
Yeah.
King Croc BBC, King Croc LBC.
King Croc EBT.
LBC.
That's a
new one.
King Croc LLC.
Yeah. But no, man, honestly, man, I really just feel like I've grown. And I understand,
You know, I just need to chill out.
King Croc, you got to stop with the slimy pickup stuff. And what I'm saying is, I don't know anybody who's successful with women who has a bunch of burner accounts on Tinder, who has a bunch of fake names and fake careers, who's approaching. I like the enthusiasm with which you approach women on the streets. I like that. That was me in college, taking every swing I could. But I don't. You just got to be more honest, I suppose.
Maybe you're right.
You got a good job now.
He treats it like a business, man. He has an ex. He has an Excel spreadsheet with all the leads he's gathered and have not gathered. And he has them all color coordinated.
They're color coded for accuracy, tracking purposes and such. But
nice.
There's nothing. No, honestly, though, people, is that psychotic?
No.
Is that psychopathic?
I don't think it's psychotic. I know of successful pickup artists, guys who get a lot of pussy, who do similar things. I just don't know of any guys who are successful with women who have fantasy identities. I think you need to get rid of that shit, dude. I think that is killing your confidence in you because you're admitting to yourself that or you're telling yourself that a girl won't like you unless your name's Dio and you're a pilot, or unless your name is Sammy and you're a trans DJ, or your name is T-Bone and you're a martial artist. You need to let girls know that you're King Croc, you're a salesman, and you're on a big comedy YouTube channel.
And you got a BBC.
Yeah, I'm a BBC. I'm a BBC.
But no fake African accents.
Yeah.
We all love genuine you for stuff. Who you are,
it,
bro.
I get it. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
We love you for you, bro.
Appreciate it.
All right. That's a good note to go out on.
Yeah.
Do you have anything to say before we wrap up today, Swolbs? What's been going on in Swolby world?
I just signed up for a comp in August. And I also started some live streaming shit. So I'm on YouTube and fucking Twitch. But the age restricted Twitch where I can say faggot and fuck.
They have that, Austin?
Yeah.
This is the first time I've heard of it.
There's no way that Twitch would allow that.
Yeah. No, I just do my shit. They don't tell me anything.
But you're probably so small, no mod has sniffed your page.
I have no, like, I only get like four viewers a fucking stream.
Yeah. I cannot believe. Are you looking that up, Austin? I can't believe that Twitch would announce publicly, we're okay with saying faggot. We're okay with transphobic language. Do whatever you want. Just do it on our age restricted platform.
In the chat, though, the moderators will take any like offensive language out, but you can approve it. You could be like, okay, yeah, that's fine. I'll let it slide.
That would be sweet if this were all true. It seems like Patreon is giving less and less of a fuck about what people do with their content, because Patreon used to be hardcore social justice warrior, and now it seems like more and more controversial figures. Yeah, it was a controversy. When I first got on Patreon like 2.5 years ago, the dude Sargon of Akkad got booted from the platform. You want to weigh in on this, King Croc?
No, I was going to add in, come in later. I was like, keep going, dude.
Sure, yeah. You just seemed real excited for a second. He got, maybe, I do want you on the mic for this, because he got banned for anti-black slurs, but he was using them to illustrate somebody else's racism.
He was calling Richard Spencer and like the alt-right guys the N-word to fuck with them.
Yeah,
he was. So like, he was talking to racists in a debate with them, calling the racist guys the N-word.
Was he black?
No.
He was calling white supremacists the N-word as to like prove a point.
Yeah,
he was like saying this is what you're doing, and he did it to them.
Oh.
I read it too. There was definitely context.
Yeah,
context matters on YouTube. For instance, you can drop N-bombs on YouTube if they're in a comedy routine, if they're in context. But if you're driving by a bus stop in Birmingham, Alabama, and just screaming the N-word, they're going to take down the video.
You can't even. But can't you not read like Tom Sawyer?
You definitely can on YouTube.
Out loud
on YouTube.
A white guy reading it out loud.
For sure, you can. Yeah, I have.
I don't know.
Yeah, you definitely can, because that's in context. YouTube.
You did do that, actually. That exact thing.
I made
you
girls do it.
Oh, you made them?
I made girls do it in the hottest fan contest.
Totally.
For all the shit YouTube gets, it is a very free platform. There are some people they just fuck over.
Mm-hmm.
Like Mumkey Jones, they just fucked over. Mm-hmm. Or who else am I thinking about? Austin will give me better examples of this.
There's a guy named Sinantra says he always gets... He got like his whole channel demonetized for no reason.
Yeah. There are people that they will just fuck. If there's a flavor of the week thing that they're getting hate about on the internet, mm-hmm. for example, school shootings were super taboo when they took down Mumkey Jones's channel, and he had three videos that were comedically praising the kid up at UCSB who went on his killing spree, Elliot Rogers. Mm-hmm. So that was the flavor of the week thing that's not allowed on YouTube, so his channel was the thing that had to come down.
They said he got banned specifically for reading the manifesto. Like he they have it. A rule against reading manifestos.
That's
from,
stupid.
From mass murder.
They made. Is, they had to have made
burning,
that.
In my opinion.
Yeah, that's stupid.
They had to have made that in response to him doing that. It had to have been like they made a bunch of new anti-bullying rules after this Carlos Maza Steven Crowder thing broke.
Steven Crowder, he's completely demonetized, and what they held over his head was. He had a t-shirt for sale that said socialism is for figs, but it kind of looks like it says socialism is for fags. On a separate website, and YouTube said that you have to stop selling that t-shirt, otherwise we're going to demonetize your whole channel if you don't.
What? He was also saying stuff. Steven Crowder is pretty gnarly. He does not give a shit.
Yeah, he goes hard.
That guy's, like, he was calling Carlos Maza a lispy queer, things of that nature. He was going pretty hard.
But that guy also calls himself a lispy queer, too, sometimes.
Sure.
Yeah.
But it's different coming from Steven Crowder. True, and true, I think true. Carlos Maza fucking stinks. Don't get me wrong. Yeah. I read that guy's tweets sometimes just to get myself really angry. if it's been a good month and I forget what anger feels like, all I have to do is go to Carlos Maza's Twitter page.
Yeah.
Don't you think it would be crazy, though, if YouTube approached you and was like, you have to stop selling the Danny Mullen Freed the Slave shirt on your own website, otherwise we're going to demonetize your YouTube channel.
But listen to this. Everybody on the fucking internet was going after YouTube during that incident. Advertisers were threatening to pull out. Everybody with a pussy who's ever been to San Francisco was on Twitter telling them that they need to deplatform Steven Crowder. And to their credit, Susan Wojcicki stood up at a press conference and said she stood by the platform's decision to not deplatform Steven Crowder. She did not back down. People, a conversation leaked of some feminist who went to Stanford or some shit trying to get Susan Wojcicki to ban Ben Shapiro from the platform. A private conversation leaked in which Susan Wojcicki said, you're not suggesting I censor Ben Shapiro, are you? Because he definitely doesn't violate guidelines. Is that really what you're suggesting to me right now? You're being ridiculous. Yeah. Susan Wojcicki isn't an insane SJW.
She was talking to a lady who was mad that her son was becoming conservative through watching Ben's videos.
Yeah.
Oh, I remember that.
Yeah.
Yeah. So YouTube.
Wild, dude.
YouTube isn't that bad, but all it would take would be a new CEO who's 20 years younger and who went to Amherst or some liberal arts college and identifies as they, and that might all change.
There's definitely a problem with people with pussies and being on Twitter. If that stopped, I think a lot of problems would stop.
We need an all-male Twitter.
Mm-hmm.
What could it be called? All of our improv skills are flagging right now.
I was going to say, like, Cox or something.
Cox.
I wouldn't make fun of you, but I got nothing better right now, King. Nothing.
Me neither, dude.
All right, guys. That has been a fun episode of the Leo and Danny Show.
I loved it. It was a great time.
That was a great show, boys.
You helped me with my depression. I feel
Hell
better.
Yeah, Croc.
Yes.
I'm not sure how, but I guess just hanging out with friends, talking, socializing, much like Cigar Guy had to do in his 12-step program for getting over anxiety.
Yeah.
Mm.
Yeah.
I hope you guys are getting over your anxiety too.
Me too, bro. Me too.
We're good. We're done.
All right.